A few weeks ago, we took apart a brand new Apple 20 watts charger. We've taken apart this charger multiple times before, but many audiences reminded us that we never did a review video of this charger. So today, let's review the charging performance of the new Apple 20 watts charger. Firstly, let's briefly introduce this familiar charger. You can also jump to the test chapter. The appearance of this charger still adopts Apple's consistent design. The input prongs cannot be folded. Here is the USB-C port on the top. This vaccine foam shows its model is A2940. It supports input of 120V, 50 or 60Hz, 0.5A, and it also supports output of 5V, 3A, or 9V, 2.22A. The manufacturer is Cellcom. The size of this charger is about 41.5 by 42.5 by 27mm, and the weight of this charger is about 58.5 grams. The Charger Power ZKM003C shows it only supports PD 2.0 and DCP charging protocols. And it also supports two fixed PDOs of 5V, 3A, and 9V, 2.22A. Then let's try to charge it with iPhone, Android phones, and other laptops. It has the best compatibility with Apple devices, and since its output power is not that high, most devices can reach more than 70 watts, only a few devices can reach about 10 watts. Next, we'll use it to fully charge the iPhone 14 Plus. The charging curve can be divided into four parts. In the first part, the power is pretty stable at around 19.5 watts. After 37 minutes, the power gradually drops to 15 watts, 8.5 watts. The final part begins at 1 hour, and the voltage also drops from 9 volts to 5 volts. It takes another hour to drop to almost zero. The total charging time is about 2 hours and 11 minutes. We also turn it into another curve. The charger can charge the iPhone 14 Plus to 50% in 32 minutes, and it can reach 80% in an hour, 100% in 2 hours and 11 minutes. The charging time is basically the same as the old Apple 20 watts we tested before. As for the standby power part, the power consumption at 220 volts, 50Hz is 0.021 watts and 0.018 watts at 110 volts, 60Hz, which is about 0.184 and 0.158 kilowatt hour in 1 year, respectively. The result is extremely impressive, almost zero. You won't feel an increase in your electricity bill at all. In the conversion efficiency test, the conversion efficiency varies from 85.52% to 89.73% at 220 volts, 50Hz. The conversion efficiency varies from 84.65% to 88.73% at 110 volts, 60Hz. The conversion efficiency reaches the average among all chargers we tested. Next, let's test its ripple. The lower ripple means better quality. Firstly, let's check out its ripple without load. The overall ripple is very stable at different voltages, maintaining at 15 to 18 mV peak to peak. Then move to the ripple test when loaded. The overall ripples are higher than without load. When the output is 9V, 2.22A, the highest ripple is 47.2 and 36.8 mV peak to peak, respectively. When the output is 5V, 3A, the lowest ripple is 28 and 34.4 mV peak-to-peak, respectively. It follows the low ripple feature, just like the Apple 5W charger. We also put the charger into a 25 degrees Celsius thermal tank throughout the test. After an hour of 20W output, we got the maximum temperature. Under 220 volts, 50Hz, the front is 42.1 degrees Celsius and the back is 49.5 degrees Celsius. Moving on to the 110 volts, 60Hz. The maximum temperature on the front and back is 46 degrees Celsius and 52.9 degrees Celsius, respectively. It's slightly higher than your body temperature and compliance with the IEC 62368 standard. You will feel warm but not hot. Well, that's all our tests for the Apple 20 watts charger. As the most common 20 watts charger on the market, even if the internal power IC is changed, its performance does not change a lot. It has good compatibility and ultra-low standby power consumption. The conversion efficiency and ripple performance are also outstanding. If you don't care about size and price, it's the one you can't go wrong with. Okay, that's all for today's video. Don't forget to drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!